Hi, I'm Scott Giroux, and welcome to another episode of Power Apps Cafe. In this episode, we're going to be talking about app convergence. And if you are extending model-driven apps using HTML, JavaScript, TypeScript, then this is going to be an important video for you to watch. It's a subtle topic, but it doesn't get talked about enough. So before that, cue the intro. Well, we've all been there. Our users or our customers have been asking for a very specific user interface, you know, a button in a particular way, a grid in a certain place. And Canvas apps are fantastic for that. If you're using model-driven apps, then the opportunities are a little bit less fantastic. You have to revert to programming using TypeScript and JavaScript and HTML. With app convergence, and I'm sure you've heard about it, it's about being able to have Canvas apps inside model-driven apps, you know, and if you look at the Merriam-Webster definition of what convergence is, one of the definitions is the emerging of distinct technologies, industries or devices. But the important thing for me, I think, is the fact that it talks about into a unified whole, because it's almost like this difference between Canvas apps and model-driven apps are almost at odds with each other. You know, they are on one hand super, super, super flexible. You can do anything. You know, you can make your user interface as gary as you like, or really quite boring. You know, but with model-driven apps, it's always going to look the same. So, you know, when we had Adrian Orth announce the custom pages, which was part of the converging model-driven apps and Canvas apps, and that was back in July, July last year. It was fantastic, you know. But I was thinking, well, how is this actually going to affect us? Because we don't really want to have this jarring experience of the user going from this incredibly consistent model-driven app experience into this anything goes Canvas app world. Greg Lindhorst is an amazingly clever person at Microsoft, principal PM architect for the Power Apps team. And he's the main lead on PowerFX, which is the language behind Canvas apps, of course, and custom pages. And he describes it as Excel-like. And so if you're writing HTML web resources today, you could be forgiven for thinking, why do I need PowerFX in Canvas apps? Because, you know, you've probably got your own user interface library, and indeed, you know, with Sparkle XREM, which is a library I created seeming like many, many moons ago now. But the idea was that you had all these components that allowed you to create user interfaces that look native to Dynamics 365 apps. And if you've ever tried to create a Canvas app that looks native to a model-driven app, you'll know that it is actually quite complicated. So you could be forgiven for thinking, I don't need Canvas apps and PowerFX. I'm just going to do it using my React extensions, and I'm going to build the whole thing out. So what's the reason to use PowerFX at all, given that you can use libraries like Fluent UI and React and things like to make a user interface extension inside a model-driven app to make it very easily make it look like a model-driven app as far as the user's concerned? Well, obviously, PowerFX is very prevalent in the Power Platform already. You know, it's being used to replace JavaScript in places like Command Bar, and the calculated columns, which you've seen come from Dataverse for Teams, and obviously now custom pages. But I think for me, the subtle shift and the reason that app convergence is so important is about lowering the total cost of ownership of our model-driven apps. And more important, this shift to declarative programming. And I think this is what doesn't get talked about enough, because yes, low code is great. I think we all agree on that. But why is low code great? It's not necessarily because it's simpler. Because if you've ever created a Canvas app, you'll know that actually it can be quite complicated, especially if you're doing something like, you know, extending a model-driven app in terms of, you know, creating a custom page, interact with Dataverse. But the declarative nature of it is what the programming industry have been constantly moving in this direction. They're constantly trying to move more and more declarative, and importantly, less and less imperative, because a TypeScript HTML web resource or a C# extension is imperative. You are being very, very specific on what you want the platform to do. A common analogy is with fixing a car, right? I know nothing about cars, for full disclosure, so I don't know any of the right terminology, but this makes a lot of sense to me, okay? But imperative is like inviting your friend over and telling them to fix your car by saying, can you pick up that spanner and undo that nut, and then could you take the old carburetor out and put the new one in? And if something breaks, it's not your friend's fault, it's you, because you were telling them to do it step by step. And you might have told them the wrong steps, and there may be something that's lost in translation. But declarative programming, which is where we're trying to move to, is where you simply ask them over and say, can you fix my car? Because there's something wrong with the carburetor, right? And if something goes wrong, well, it's probably down to their skills, nothing to do with you. Obviously, we all need friends to come and help us fix our car. We all need friends like that. But the key is, with declarative programming inside a model-driven app and custom pages, we will be interacting with Dataverse by requesting data and then patching that data. There'll be security concerns, there'll be localization concerns, and the declarative programming, we don't have to worry about caching of that data. We don't have to worry about checking of certain security checks. We don't have to worry about the performance of the UI rendering. Most of that is handled for us because we're simply telling the platform what we want to do, not how we want to do it. And so with custom pages, we can now put this declarative user interface inside model-driven apps, either in a full page or in a pop-up dialogue or a sidebar or a side panel on the right-hand side. And so all these places that give us the opportunity to start to pop in very custom interfaces. Now, I tried to do this. So this is me trying to replicate the deal manager that you get with a sales premium license. Okay, so this actually is a custom page here. So we've got a model-driven app, and you know, you can select a particular opportunity. You can go and edit that opportunity by, and this is patching it against the data source. And we've got a grid down the bottom here, which allows me to kind of filter. I can kind of filter a particular item here. So this is if I look down here, I've got all my items, and I can start to, you know, edit the probability on this. I've got all of that responsivity that you get with custom apps. So if I, you know, resize this, you know, it's going to resize all of the user interface. So all the things you'd kind of expect, and it looks like a model-driven app. So how did I do this, and what were the challenges? So if we switch over into actually what that looks like inside our custom page editor, most of this is actually done using PowerFX. If you look at my controls that I've got available, I've got four custom controls here. So we've got a drag and drop control, we've got a fluent grid, a command bar, and a power apps chart. So the editing, if you look at the layout here, we've got just using responsive stacks here, with the child stacks inside, with containers, with just normal text fields. And the great thing is that when you have a custom page, it uses the fluent UI controls rather than the controls from canvas apps. It uses a different set of controls that look like model driven apps. So we only need to use code components, custom components that are obviously imperative in their very nature to do these more complex areas where, like the grid, the editable grid. If you were trying to do that using all of the native controls inside a custom page and PowerFX, it would be very complex and also perform particularly poorly. And likewise for things like the command bar that you want to have, if we just run it here, you know, you want to have like a flyout. So this subtle shift is more about move as much of our functionality away from imperative programming, which we had previously done, into the PowerFX layer, and start to move our imperative programming down as small as possible inside these reusable components. So previously you'd have Canvas apps separate, and maybe they'd be embedded inside of model-driven apps, and you could use code components previously as well. And then all the goodness of model-driven apps. But now what's happening is that PowerFX is the glue inside Power Apps to bring everything together. And what that means, and I think this is a really important thing, is that it means that we are trying to make the code components that are imperatively programmed as small as possible, and put as much of all the glue and all the plumbing and accessing data sources inside PowerFX. Because in that app that I built, there was no data access directly inside my code components. It was just simply using the standard PowerFX connections to Dataverse. This journey that we've been going on to move away from imperative to declarative programming, goodness me, it's been since the beginning of programming, you know, from assembly language into C, C++, moving up to higher level languages, 4GLs. And, you know, this is a journey that we're constantly going on. And this is just the next step of that. But if you are today building HTML web resources, and this perhaps is the main takeaway, perhaps you're making code components that are very, very complicated, start to think about how can we move more of that functionality out of those HTML web resources, out of those code components, is into the PowerFX layer and embed them inside the custom page. And so what that will mean is that over time, you know, you're going to get a lot less maintenance overheads with, as a platform gets upgraded, you won't have to worry about so much about performance and security, all those things. I think certainly the declarative story is going to be a key part of where we see the platform moving in. So when you think about low code, or when you hear low code, equate it with declarative programming. And I think that will unlock the real benefits of why we're moving in this definition. It's not just about less code, it's about declarative code. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. Please subscribe to my video, if my YouTube channel, if you've not already, and let me know in the comments any thoughts you have. Maybe you completely disagree with everything I've said, and that's fine. But whatever, have a great day, and I will see you next time. Cheers.